Lord in prayers. Lord, we thank you for these testimonies that we have received. We thank you for your blessings upon your children. We know that there are some, their struggles are before you, and they are with us. And we thank you because you've been intervening on our behalf. For healings, for protection, for safety, we thank you. As we continue in prayers, for the few minutes that we have to spend together, we pray that you will lead us to pray aright. I ask in Jesus' name. Amen. I just want to briefly read a passage that will help us as we pray. It will be a reminder for us, as we do every year, to encourage each other on a particular direction. I recall very well when we came 1st January 2019, one of the encouragements we had for all of us towards each other is to love one another. If you remember very well, that was the encouragement that we received from God's word. Now, when we receive one for this year, it does not necessarily mean that we have become experts in loving one another. No, we can only keep talking about things we will do to be building on what we are doing. We are not there yet, but we are encouraged to continue with that. But today we want to read Matthew 26. Matthew 26, from verse 36. Matthew 26, from verse 36. I'll read from the New NIV Translation. Then Jesus went with his disciples to a place called Gethsemane, and he said to them, "Sit here while I go over there and pray." He took Peter and the two sons of Zebedee along with him, and he began to be sorrowful and troubled. Then he said to them, "My soul is overwhelmed with sorrow to the point of death. Stay here and keep watch with me." Going a little farther, he fell with his face to the ground and prayed, "My Father, if it is possible, may this cup be taken from me. Yet, not as I will, but as you will." Then he returned to his disciples and found them sleeping. "Couldn't you men keep watch with me for 1 hour?" he asked Peter. "Watch and pray so that you will not fall into temptation. The spirit is willing, but the flesh is weak." The Lord bless the reading of his word. Watch and pray. If I have any encouragement for us as to how to go about conducting ourselves as we live in these times, is to watch our prayer. You remember that this happened to Christ just at the point of the crucifixion, and he was preparing himself for the cross. To watch in this context does not mean to look, but the idea has to do with being alert, to be alert, especially in the context of a night guard. Somebody who's a security man and is doing night shift. The reason why you would want to encourage a night guard to be alert is because darkness is very much around him, and danger can come through the guise or under the cover of dark. And to the watchman, if care is not taken, you'll be taking unawares, if not alert. Now, the average watching that a daytime guard will do is different from what a night shift guard will do. In the accounts that we have read, you will see that Jesus' disciples, when they were to watch along with him allow their physical needs to overwhelm and overpower their desire to obey the instruction of Jesus Christ. And this is the situation that we are very familiar with. Have that moments you want to carve out to be in prayers. There is also this angle of the physical need that will want to pull you down and hinder you from attaining or achieving that goal. Somebody asked a question from the seminar, and I said, maybe somebody should write a paper. He says, why is it that other activities in the church, people don't sleep, but when it is sermon time, a lot of people begin to sleep? I said, well, that should be a thesis for him to do the research on. But I said to him, I am thinking two things. The moment somebody, look at children, when children are very active and are running around and you force them to sit in one place and be attentive, what is the next thing? So when you ask somebody to pay attention to something, to be still and be quiet and to pay attention, there is a tendency that the needs of the body will want to take over. And then you are uploading heavy bites for the people to take in, right? If care is not taken, there is that tendency for sleep to occur. Prayer requires a lot of discipline and commitment. I have listened to people say, when you talk about missions, they say for some is to go, for some is to give hope, and then many will say for some is to pray. And they feel that prayer is the cheapest and the easiest. Many times people take prayer quickly, prayer, because it doesn't involve their pockets. How can you pray if you don't go? How can you pray if you don't give? It is when you find yourself deep in a situation that you can understand what it means to pray for that particular situation. Prayer will take a lot from each of us. That is why it requires discipline and commitment. Because it involves you paying a lot of attention, trying to zero on that particular thing you have before you as you pray unto the Lord. If we must be prayerful, then we must be very disciplined. There are no two ways about it. You must be able to beat this body and cause it to submit to the will of God that is ahead of your comfort and the desires that the body has. Why should we pray? Why must we be prayerful? I know it is very clear for us believers in Nigeria that we have a lot ahead of us, even as individuals and as believers, as a community in this country. There's so much. As an individual, there are things you want to achieve. As an individual, there are places you want to go to. As an individual, there are many things that you need to do. As a community, we have a common goal that we are pursuing. We have a common enemy, the devil, that is attacking us in many ways. To succeed, we must be vigilant. And we must be in tune with Jesus Christ, the author and the finisher of our faith. We must, it's not a suggestion, we must be vigilant and we must be in tune with God. So in the place of prayer, we are able to be in tune with God. But before we could do that, we must be very, very vigilant. We must look away from the distractions of the flesh. Because the body has its desires, the things the body wants to achieve, the things the body wants to gain. The sensual things that the body will always desire to have. So anything that will take away those comforts from the body will protest. So we have to look away from the distractions of the flesh. We have to discipline ourselves so that we are able to overcome even the schemes of the enemy. Prayer is one active way that we show our love and we show our relationship with God. If you love God, you will pray. Because in prayer, you are able to have communion with God. You are building a relationship with God. So prayer is one way we tell God, we love you, because we want to grow in our relationship with you. So the value you attach to your relationship with God will tell a lot in how much you pray. A lot of times, prayers, we've turned them to be when we are looking for something. When we have needs, when we are plagued by the challenge, that is when it comes to our minds to pray. But we do not see prayer as a way of telling God how much we love you. But when we tell each other, especially in either marriage relationships or the one that is always hot, is when young people tell each other that they love each other and they want to marry each other. I'm talking about very good Christian relationship. I'm talking about the one that they go and snap by the root. If that is the one you are doing, that is not the one I'm referring to. I'm referring to a good and working relationship. That for some of you here, in the first quarter, you have already booked for dates that you will get married. Okay. I think first quarter of this year, first quarter alone, we have close to four or so weddings. Alright, they are coming up. Don't worry, you'll begin to receive the announcements. But you see, we make effort to be with one another, to spend time so that we will build a relationship. And if you don't spend time with your lover will tell you, you don't care about me. You have time to do A, B, and C, but not me. So, that is the point that I'm trying to communicate here. If you claim that you love God, then you spend time building your relationship with God in the place of prayers. Prayers will walk along with the studying of God's word. I don't want for us to feel the two are separated. Because when you pray, when you read God's word, you are able to know the mind of God. And then it helps you in praying and communing with God. And I dare to say, and this is, I'm not removing myself from this so that it don't look like I am perfect and I'm there and I'm speaking down to all of us. This is what we all need to do. The struggles of the flesh, all of us are on this battle together to overcome. So you tell God how much you love God by how you commune with Him. And my interest here is not to talk about the different modes of prayer, whether you kneel down when you're praying. I know people who walk and pray. I know people who can pray through singing. I know people who pray while lying down and sit there asleep. I don't know. I know many postures you can take, many modes. The most important thing is you have to propose in your heart that you want your relationship with God to grow. So that in everything you are doing, you are conscious of your relationship with God. Prayer is one key thing that continues to connect us in that relationship with God. Prayer is walking in step with God. When you neglect your prayer life, you will create a disconnect with God. Psalm 145 verse 18 says, "The Lord is near to all who call on Him, to all who call on Him in truth." God is near to all who call on Him. We also pray for one another. So the first instance is about you and God in your relationship with Him, but then we also pray for one another. In fact, the Bible tells us to also pray for our enemies. Right? Are we together? The Bible encourages us to what? Pray for our enemies. Invariably, what the Lord is saying to us is to love our enemies. When we talk about loving one another, you can't pray for someone if you don't love them. Because you are praying to God by way of expressing your love for God. So So outside of love, I don't know how you can pray. We do not pray for evil to succeed. So when we pray for wickedness, for those who are evil, it doesn't mean that we are praying for their evil to succeed. No. But that we are praying for evil people to be overcome by good. And the scripture teaches us to do that. We speak to evil situations in our country. We speak against it. We speak against bad governance when it exists. It doesn't mean we hate those in leadership, but we have refused, as God's children, to be like the world. We have refused to accept evil to exist in our societies. So we speak against evil and its dominance. We actively engage our societies with the gospel of Jesus Christ. But we pray for those engaging in evil, for the Lord to rescue them and open their eyes. Has he been doing that? Yes, he has. You don't have to see it to know that he's doing it, but he has been doing it. I just want to say some few lines as we close the prayers. John chapter 14 and 15 tells us this one thing, that we must watch and pray so that we may obey and remain faithful. So why must we watch and pray? So that we obey and remain faithful to God. To obey God and to remain faithful to God. And so in these passages, you will see the resources that God has made available for us to obey and remain faithful to God, and the benefits that will come to God's children by the name of that. Secondly, we must watch and pray that we will not fall into temptation. That is captured in Matthew 26, especially verse 41, the passage we have read. We must watch and pray that we will not fall into temptation. So God has made his resources available to help us not to fall into temptation. But we have to be actively engaged in praying for the grace to succeed. Thirdly, we must watch and pray in order to understand the end times. In fact, if you like, to understand the times, because we already know that we are in the end times. Luke 21, especially chapter 21 will tell us this, but verse 36 will underscore this point, how that we must watch and pray so that we are able to understand the times. We must also pray for endurance and freedom from distraction. Hebrews 12:2, Luke 18:1, Ephesians 6:8. For the grace to be able to pray, we must pray as well. For the grace that God will rescue us from distractions, we must pray. And finally, 1 Thessalonians 5:17 tells us, we must pray without ceasing. We must pray non-stop. Now, don't look at me to tell you what praying non-stop prayer means. Whether you start praying from 8 a.m. to the next day 8 a.m. and then you continue from the next day 8 a.m. to another day 8 a.m. I don't know if that is what it means. But the point is, we must remain active in keeping our link with our Master. If we must succeed in this trying time. Jesus made these statements when he was faced with the cross. And we live in very troubling times, especially in our country, but globally, it's the same story. For us to stand firm, we must pray. So I don't know what this year, what you have in front of you for this year. I don't know what distractions are waiting for us out there. But that when we will come here, if the Lord tarries, 1st January 2021, then we will be able to tell ourselves that indeed in the year 2020. I have watched, I have remained alert, and I have prayed. Can this be a year that we will say we have grown in our prayer life? That is the challenge before us. A lot as predicted by plenty people from plenty places. A lot will be happening in Nigeria this year. But as I said on Sunday, you have no idea what the Lord has averted on our behalf in the past. It is because the faithfuls prayed. That team is very small. We need to increase so that we are able to find respite as we live in this world. You may have many things you want to achieve. There are many, many things you want to pursue. Can you make praying and watching top on the list? Let's bow to God in prayer. Tell God that you want to be prayerful and watchful in 2020. You want to be more prayerful and more watchful than you were in the past in this 2020. You want to grow in your prayer life.